Hi, good day. This is Patrick again. So I'm just showing off some features I like with the Shield TV 2017. So I've been with other Android TVs like the Mi Box, and I have a modified Android TV. It's like a Kata box running Mi OS with Android TV, but so far this is the best Android TV experience I ever got hold of. So same recommendation. So you can see Metal Gear. That is for NVIDIA games. So HBO Go. So Hulu. So you still have the same functionality actually from other Android TV. But what sets this apart is that it gives you tons of games to play with. So here we go. So let me show you. So I still have Plex, BBC iPlayer, I have Amazon Video. So as you can see here, it's like a Play Store for video games. So these are the games that I played a while ago. So you have GeForce Now, you have GameStream, this is games under on your PC that you can stream. So let me just show you. So there are lots of games here to choose. So we could go to new games for GeForce Now. So that's there's Outlast, Outlast 2. And there are free ones that are included in the subscription. I'm currently on trial for 30 days, so I'm thinking of continuing my service. It's like $7.99 a month, and it's pretty good. So let me show you. So GeForce Now, there you go. There are lots of games here. So I counted them all, maybe around 50 plus games included. They're old games or new, quite new games. Quite some old games too. So I think it's okay. I'm trying right now the Batman Arkham City, or all the Batman games there. So and let me go back here. So they're saying that you need at least 25 Mbps to properly stream your game. So right now what I did was I'm currently on 50 Mbps connection fiber, but unfortunately it's capped, so I need to save some bandwidth playing games or streaming games. So if you can see here, Asia Pacific North, that's the service location. Stream quality. So I know it's 720p 30 FPS and max bit rate. I pegged it to 4 Mbps. So just so you know, if you have a DSL connection, if you have like 8 Mbps or 5 Mbps connection or 10 Mbps, I'm not sure. Maybe you can still play it. I'm not sure because the fiber have like lower latency, but for DSL has much higher latency. So I'm just showing you that you can actually play it under 4 Mbps connection. So that's pretty good. So if you're saving bandwidth, you just need to tweak some options there, and voila. And you can actually play those games even if you're not having, or even if you don't have any high speed connection. So let me see here. Let's play Street Fighter. So let me just look here. Let me go up here. GeForce Now. Okay, Street Fighter versus Tekken. So let's see if we can play it right now. So it's actually pretty stable. Even if you have like, even if you pegged it to 4 Mbps, it will give you a great gameplay. So don't worry about having a 25 Mbps connection or higher. I tried it on a connection on 50 Mbps, and it's great. It's the gameplay was awesome. So even if I lowered it to 4 Mbps, it's still great. So here we go. So as you can see, it says that for smoother streaming, it will lower down the resolution to 720p.
Stream Fighter Cross Tekken!
Let's play the arcade.
The news of Pandora has reached Ryu thanks to Chun-Li as she tracks Shadow's move.
Okay, let's leave. So you can see on top, that's a signal. That's the speed of your connection. Since I'm just only using 4 Mbps.
Let the madness begin! Lots of games here to play. So game stream, that's basically like Moonlight. So okay, let's go out here and let me show you the settings. So shield accessories, shield controller. Can actually set the OK Google detection to on, and it's always on all the time. So it sucks the batteries of the shield controller. So you can turn it off, like OK Google disabled, so it will not listen to you all the time or listen to you. So let's go to the settings. So network, just normal Android TV. So currently on 5 GHz connection or AC, wireless AC. So display, So power control. So that's HDMI CEC. HDMI settings. If you disable this, you will have lots of options to choose from. You can see the color space. There you go. So I'll just leave it to auto. HDMI mode, you can set high quality stereo, stereo 5.1. And if your TV doesn't support overscan, there you go. Set option. So system. Okay, there's. You can change the brightness of the LED of your Shield TV to high or low. So I leave it low. So processor mode. It was set on default to max performance. So just put it under optimize. It's still. Still works well. You get a lower benchmark for a future mark if you just lower that to optimize, but still good. So space, you can see here network storage. You can actually mount your storage device, your NAS or your share folders from another PC. So let me just show you. So if I go here on, this is my Fire Explorer. So these are all the files, or these are all the shared folders from my other PC and another PC. So I can achieve all those files directly using this one. So for example, I have PSPP, yeah, this one. So I don't need to copy it to the Shield. So it's like you're having so let me just show you. So God of War, let's go. So it's actually loading from the network drive, the ISO. So let me load the state here. This one is actually loading from the network drive, the ISO for this one. So it's pretty good. This is one of the features that I like from the Shield. So if you have like media files or ISO files that you need to load, just make sure you have a fast internet or you have a fast wireless connection. Because if not, then I believe it will lag sometimes because. It's loading the file over the network. So as you can see, emulation for God of War is pretty good. I'm getting 60 frames per second and 100%, almost 100% game for speed. Well, when I was using the Mi Box or the S905 Amlogic chipset, I was actually just getting like less than 20 frames per second, or sometimes I'm getting 30 frames per second. This one is pretty good. Show you the settings. My current settings for God of War, I'm currently running it on Vulkan,
So not OpenGL, so it's, I believe it's more faster. There you go. Rendering resolution, display resolution, native device resolution. The quality is actually good, if you can see that. Okay, let's go out here. Okay, BBC. We're recording right now, so it's not allowing me to load the application. Let me see if we could load that Amazon. Oh, there you go. Let's load it up. So there you go. So power options. We just have sleep now and restart, but actually have a hidden power off option here. So just go to here, power off. So it will completely turn off your shield. So I believe it's a pretty great option. I hope they put it there on the menu or outside, so it's gonna be better. So overall experience of the shield, I got it from Amazon on a Black Friday sale for $169. So I believe it's a very good deal. So I have the game controller, I have the remote, I have all the games that I needed to play here. So Rush Rally, if you can see, Rush Rally is really optimized to play in 60 FPS with all the details. So basically that's it. So I'll try to share more of my experience with the shield as time goes by. Maybe after 2 weeks, and I'll show some more stuff that I learned with this awesome Android TV box. Again, thank you.